Hello YouTube, welcome to New State News episode, the format that sums up all hardware and software gear news from the last week. Another week is finished, the coronavirus is a big topic in the media, but not here. I have the hottest synthesizer news from the last week that you must know, so don't panic, let's have fun and let's go! Almost 8 years ago, Yonex Magellan synthesizer saw the iOS world for the first time, and it plays until today an important part in my love for iOS apps, mainly because it was one of my first downloaded synthesizer apps for iOS that I enjoyed from the first minute. At that time, there were some synth apps, but only a few sounded great and offers a user-friendly interface like Magellan. 8 years have passed and the app is still up to date. That's what Yonark the developer through, but go several steps further by applying the complete wellness queue. The result is called Magellan 2, is a new app and offers many new features and sounds while preserving the best known soul of the original app. Yeah, an app can have a soul. Big new features are audio unit support, MPE via additional in-app purchase, warmer filters, a new interface, new modulation options and many new presets. If you love the first version of Magellan, the second is a must-have. Who is the king of free plugins? Of course, Fullbucket Music. Last week he made a comeback with a new free synthesizer plugin. Trisynth MK3 is an emulation of the classic Korg Trident synthesizer from 1982. As always, it's written in C++ code, so the CPU consumption is very low. Trisynth is polyphonic, you can choose between 8 or 64 voices, and like the original, it offers 3 different sections. Synthesizer, brass and string. To refine the sounds, you get also a nice sounding flanger and ensemble effect. Very handy, all parameters can be controlled by MIDI CC. Check out my channel, I recently uploaded a sound demo of it. In terms of sound quality, it can totally convince me, and in my opinion the plugin is a great release, which you should not miss. Thanks Björn. Last week Electron also unveiled its new product. This was leaked the day before at a shop, so the usual bad people. Model Cycles is a compact 6-track groovebox which comes in the same design as the model samples. Very simple in white and not very sexy to be honest, but with a light blue knobs that stands out. Electron makes work easy here. They took the same housing and installed a different internal hardware. Or it's just another software code, we don't know it. We may get more if we unscrew both devices and compare the inside. I can't do this because I'm not on a list of Electron for making reviews. Let's go back to the facts. Model Cycles relies on simplified FM synthesis. Available are 6 different instruments or machines: kick, snare, metal, perk, tone and Korg, which are adjustable with 4 controllers. Unfortunately, you can go deeper in the synthesis than this. So if you want to go deeper, I would recommend an Electron Digitone. Further, you can refine your sounds with a delay and reverb effect. The rest is similar to the model samples. All 6 tracks can be operated as audio or MIDI tracks, so like the sample version, it can also be used as a MIDI sequencer. You can create up to 96 projects, and in each project you can save up to 96 patterns, which is enough for bigger performances. At first glance, Electron has developed a nice compact FM groove box that is perfect for beginners. If you already have a Digitone in the studio, I don't think you need this new groovebox, or just if you are an absolute fanboy of the brand. The Digitone remains more complex and versatile than that. However, the Model Cycles is simpler and far more hands-on for everyone. And one thing, I'm still not understand why they don't develop these machines with battery operation. Why Electron? Continue with a project that is particularly exciting for software developers. We know that there are more music tech software developers than hardware. No wonder the cost to develop a hardware device are far more higher than the software code. The Daisy board from the young company Electrosmith could be the solution for many indie software developers who are interested to creating a hardware device. Daisy is a new open source developer board that simplifies hardware development. The board is based on an ARM Cortex M7 chip with 64 MB of SDRAM, which is enough for 10 minutes of audio buffer. So a lot of power in a tiny chip. This new board allows you to convert your software codes into pedals, synthesizers, samplers and eRack modules. So interesting for many different developers. What's so amazing here is that the board doesn't cost a ton of money, but only $29 on Kickstarter right now. Plus, it's suitable for many different programming languages. It supports Arduino, PureData, MaxMSP, and C++. Electrosmith goes even further. They also offer suitable hardware where you can install the board, so Daisy Pod, Daisy Patch, Daisy Paddle, and Daisy Field, so four interesting hardware products suitable to this chip. All in all, a very coherent project. It will be exciting with experimental synthesizers or effects you may see in hardware in the future. Well done, Electrosmith. Since a few days now, Polyand is teasing a new product with a big knob on Facebook. In every teaser, you can hear audio materials, but interesting here, these are not classic synth sounds, but samples. The third and latest teaser confirms that the device is very sleek and can sample. Polyand also confirms it, so it will be a new sampling instrument. Maybe they will show a virtual tape-based groovebox where you can sample audio and manipulate this in real time by sequencing or adding slices or adding granular synthesis to it. Something like a hardware version of the sampler app would be awesome. We don't know much yet, but one thing is certain, it can sample, so it will be a sampler probably. I'm very excited to see this product. It already looks now very interesting. And for the end, a nice surprise from John Bowen, sound designer of many hardware synths, including the new Korg Wavestate, but also the developer of the Solaris synthesizer. At NAMM, John presented prototypes of a new desktop version and of a voice expansion, but that's not all. Solaris will get in near future a big firmware update 2.0. The new update will add a new Yamaha DX-style 4-operator FM synthesis and Casio phase distortion synthesis engine, plus the synth will get a new 4-part multimode. However, they have not installed the classic FM engine here, where you can modulate operators with others using algorithms. Thanks to the modular engine of the Solaris, you can freely map oscillators in any way you like, so you can create very wild things here. I think it will be a massive sound update for this Uber synth, and I'm looking forward to hear the new sounds. I hope you enjoyed this new episode of Synth News. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think about the news? What do you think the Polyand device will be? And is the model cycles a must-have? Let me know your opinions and ideas in the comments. Big thanks for watching and hope to see you again in one of the next Synth News episodes. Bye!